Welcome to the channel. In this video, we will see how we can compile and run a C program from command prompt in Windows computer. In order to continue with this video, C toolset has to be installed in your computer. If you don't know how to do that, then I will provide a tutorial in the description box. You guys can check that out. Now here, we will make sure that C toolset, which includes the compiler and other required programs, are installed in our computer. In order to check for that, we will open up the terminal, or you can open up the command prompt also. And here in the terminal or the command prompt, we will type in gcc space minus minus version, and then we will hit the enter key in the keyboard. If you see a message like this, this version number can be different. If you don't see an error here, then it means that C toolset is installed in your computer. If you see an error, something like this, then it means that C toolset is not installed. You have to download and install it. Okay. So once C toolset is installed in our computer, we can go ahead and we can write a C program and run that program from the command prompt. Now I will use a simple text editor and I will write a very simple C program. I will use Notepad. You guys can use any other text editor. The first thing that we do once we open up the text editor is save the C source file. For that, we will click on the file and then we will click on save. Here, I will save the file in the desktop inside this C folder, and then here I have to give the name for the file. I will say application. You guys can give any appropriate name. And after that, we will have the file extension .c. .c is the file extension used for the C source files. Okay. After that, since I'm using the Notepad in here, save as type, I will make it all files, and then I will click on save. Now, once the file is saved, we can write a very simple C program. Now here, I will include the stdio.h header file. This header file provides us the functions like printf and scanf, and then we will have the main function. And in this main function, we will use the printf function and we will display a message on the screen. So here in this program, I will say hello world, and after that, in the end of this main function, we will return a value of 0, indicating that this program has executed without any issue. Now, once we have written the program, we will save that. And after that, we can close this text editor. Now, we will open up the folder where we have saved our file. If you remember, I have saved my file in desktop inside this C folder. Here, you guys can see the file application.c. Now, in order to run this program from the command prompt, what we have to do is we have to open up the command prompt or terminal with this particular path. If you're using the latest version of Windows 11, then you can right click. You will see this option, open in terminal. Click on that. It will open up the terminal with this particular path. For example, here you can see desktop C folder. But if you're using any older version of Windows, then what you can do is you can go to this navigation section, left click in your mouse. It will highlight the path like this, and then you type in CMD, and after that hit the enter key. It will open up the command prompt with this particular path. For example, here you guys can see it is desktop and then C folder. Okay, now what we have to do is we have to compile this source file and we have to create an executable file. In order to do that, we will use the command gcc. Gcc is the C compiler that is installed in this computer. And after that, we will type in the name of the file which is containing the source code. In this case, it is application.c. After that, I will hit the enter key in my keyboard. Now, nothing happens in the command prompt, but if you look at the folder in here, a new file has been created with the name A. Now this file is the executable file. We can run this file. In order to run this, in this command prompt, we will type in the name of the file, which is A, and then we will hit the enter key, and you guys can see we will get the output of this program, which is hello world. Now here, this name A is the default name that is used when we don't provide a name for the executable file. If you want, we can provide a name for the executable file when we compile the source file. To do that, we will type in gcc and then the name of the file which is containing the source code, which is application.c, and then we will write in minus o, and then we can specify the name for the executable file. For example, here I will say application.exe. exe is the extension for the executable files in Windows platform. Now here, minus o flag indicates that I want to name the output file, which is the executable file, and I want to use this particular name for that file. After that, if I hit the enter key in my keyboard, again, nothing happens in the command prompt. But if you look at this folder, a new file has been created with the name application. So when we don't provide a name for the executable file, default name of A is used. When we provide a name, that particular name is used for the executable file. Now, in order to run this, we just have to type in the name of the executable, which is the application in this particular case. If I hit the enter key, you guys can see the output, which is hello world. Now, the next thing is when we compile the source file and when we create the executable using the GCC, we can provide a lot of information for the compiler. For example, we can tell the compiler to display all the warnings, or we can tell the compiler to use a specific C standard. You know, many more things can be done. For that, we use something called as flags. For example, here, if I want the compiler to display all the warnings in the program that we have written, then we can use this flag minus wall here. It means that warning all, and then we can provide the file that we want to compile. In this case, it is application.c, and then we will use minus o and give a name for the executable file. For example, I will say app.exe. Now here, I'm just using this one flag, which will display all the warnings, if there are any warnings, for the program that we have written. If there are no warnings, then nothing will be displayed. Now, along with this particular flag, you can use many other flags. As I said before, for example, if you want to specify a particular C standard, then you can do that. Now here, if I hit the enter key, again, nothing happens, but we get this executable file in this folder called as app. Okay. Now in this program, there were no warnings, and that's why we don't see anything here. But if there were some warnings, then they would be highlighted. Just to demonstrate that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up this executable file in the Notepad. Again, you can use any text editor. And here, what I will do is I will create a variable. I will call it as x, and that's it. Now here, what I have done is I have declared this variable x, but I have not used that. Now let us see whether a warning will be issued or not. So I will bring back the terminal in here, and we will run the previous command with this warning all flag. And then if I hit the enter key in here, now you guys can see warning unused variable x. So in this particular example, in this particular case, there was this warning, and that's why this warning is displayed. Now when we have the warnings, the executable file will be created. For example, let me just give a new name in here. I will say app2.exe, and now if I run this, again you guys can see a warning is displayed in here, and the app2.exe is created. Now if there were any errors, then the executable file will not be created. but when there are warnings, you know, executable files will be created, but it will display these warnings in here. Okay, so this is it guys for this particular video. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you have anything to say, write that in the comment box. For more tutorials, subscribe to the channel.